That's the thing about museums and places like that. When you leave, it's nearly impossible to avoid the gift shop. Now, the 9/11 Memorial Museum will tell you that all sales are dedicated to developing and sustaining the National September 11 Memorial Museum. But it's not going over so well with people. The general consensus is that the gifts are insensitive and offensive. One victim's mother said, quote, "I think it's a money-making venture to support inflated salaries, and they're willing to do it over my son's dead body." One aspect of the museum is that it's not just full of pieces and the ruins of that day. It's also full of unidentified body parts of unknown victims, which means it's a tomb that's now full of overpriced knickknacks. Another victim's loved one said, quote, "Here is essentially our tomb of the unknown. To sell baubles, I find quite shocking and repugnant. Let's take a tour. You've got your token coffee mugs, shirts, hats, memorial jewelry, of course, even toys. And hey, how about that $95 Twin Tower silk scarf? Or the In Darkness We Shine Brightest hoodie for only $40. You can even get Fido and FDNY Rescue Dog Vest for $40. It goes on, and some people say, fine, you're gonna make money however you need to, but at least keep the store closed when only 9/11 relatives and rescue and recovery workers are allowed to visit. One of the Ground Zero demolition supervisors said, quote, "These people are suffering and they don't need to be reaching into their pockets. Museum could have gone 6 days without asking for money."